Hello, everybody. So today I'm reviewing The Hereafter. The Hereafter is the story of John, who returns home after serving quite a few years in prison. But he returns to school and no one really wants to forgive him for his crime. He just wants to start fresh, be at home with his father, but no one wants to forgive him for the crime that he has committed. So The Hereafter is a film that starts out with just showing this character John, him going back home, him being with his father, him being quite horrible to his father, and it takes a while for you to find out the crime that he has committed. And when you see him telling the story of the crime, there's no remorse. He isn't sorry for what he's done. And when you find out the reasoning behind what he's done, you do not care for him. You gather no sympathy for him, and you do not care for this character at all. There's only one miniature scene in the film that just where you see a tiny bit of remorse for him, and then it just sort of ends that scene, and then you're like, okay, I still don't care for this character at all. He is really horrible to this girl that he starts to like. He's really horrible to his father, and he's just not a very nice person. And when he goes into school, people bully him. And when you find out the crime, you start to understand why people are bullying him. These kids do not want him at the school for his crime, because the crime that he has committed is really, really horrible, and there's no true reasoning behind what he does. And this film sort of tries to make you care for this character, but there's nothing for you to truly invest in him or like him, because he just is pretty much an asshole throughout the whole film. And when it gets to the end, it just feels very rushed. The whole time I was watching it, I was reminded of The Hunt slightly, because of some cinematography and things in there. A mix of that being of a film of a man accused of a crime and then that he didn't do, and then all the horrible things happening to him. But this is a film where a guy has done a crime and people are doing horrible things to him. Now, this film does have beautiful cinematography, and that's the thing that stands out the most for this film. You have all these very nice long shots, and just where they film, like, it's just where the camera will be in the scenes where the camera will just be in a car and just will be still, and then there's something happening through the windshield of the car, and those are really nice things to see in the film. That's the best thing about the film, the cinematography. But this is a film that just didn't have me care for the character like it wanted you to. It wanted you to sort of feel for this character, to feel for the things that he has done, but he's not sorry for what he has done, and he's just a very horrible and deceitful person, and that's what lets The Hereafter down quite a bit. Because this could have been a film where you find out the crime and you sort of see him just trying to get through his remorse, trying to be sorry for what he's done, but he doesn't want to be. He just wants to go and do more stuff, and there's one point where he just goes and starts fighting someone, and it's like they have done something wrong to him, and there's something like with his family, but it's also where you sort of start to understand why they're doing what they're doing. And there's many unnecessary scenes in this. There's one very unnecessary scene with a dog in it where something horrible happens. It doesn't make any sense as why it was in the film. And it's a film that is an hour and 42 minutes long. But I was sat there and I began to get very bored, and it feels almost like 3 hours long. The only good thing, like I've said about The Hereafter, is the cinematography. But that's it. It's a film that wants you to care for a character who's done a horrible crime, but you do not care for the character because he doesn't have any remorse, and he's not sorry for anything that he has done. The Hereafter gets a 2 out of 5 from me. Like I said, beautiful cinematography, but that's the only good thing about the film. So that's my review for today. Thank you very much, and I shall see you all again very, very soon. Goodbye.